Hello everyone, I'm back with a new video. This time it's about the US dollar and the Swiss franc. I want to do a multi-time frame analysis, especially for educational purposes. I want to show you guys how I look at the market and how I spot or hunt for potential opportunities. So let's get into it, and I hope you learn a lot from it. And of course, at the end, we hope to identify a certain trading opportunity. So this is the weekly chart of the US dollar Swiss franc. This is the weekly chart. So from a multi time frame analysis perspective, you start on the bigger time frames. What I look for over here is what do I see? Where are interesting support and resistance areas that I need to be aware of? Well, of course, way up here there is this level where price ran into and then started selling off pretty aggressively. So this is definitely a level that will not be broken in a short time. Take a look at one of my videos about supply and demand zones. It's very interesting, I think, to take a look at these kind of levels. Then we have this low and we have this low. It's not really at the same level, but again, talking about supply and demand zones, this would definitely be an area to watch. And then we have certain zones in the middle where price tends to bounce off of, and that is, I think, for now, this was quite the level didn't get respected that much. And over here we have this level where price ran into and didn't succeed to break this as a resistance, and now it came back, tested as support, and now it's looking to act as support again. So that's the bigger picture. That's what I see on the bigger time frame. Also interesting, if you work with time frame trend lines, this of course is something that sticks out. Price rallied, came back. Also looking back, this was a area where price wasn't able to break. So we see all these pin bars, and price started rallying. Also over here we saw a same reaction in the same level, which also is supported by this trend line. Then again, we have this current level, which I talked about just now. It's also supported by the trend line. But overall, this bigger picture trend line got broken, so that could be an indication that price is not really making any new highs in the short term. But a pullback already occurred. So zoom in a little bit to the daily time frame. We see that price started to sell off from here on out. We had this first move, then a small pullback, a second move, also a small pullback, then we had a huge bearish leg, and then we came in to retest this trend line actually. And also I think we came back, or price came back to retest this previous oh wait a minute, let me put it like this. Yes, that's where I want to have it. So this was support, now it came back, was resistance. Also this trend line acts as a kind of resistance. So this was a confirmation that price was ready to go back down for the bigger picture. And we see this was a huge sell-off week almost, where price just kept dropping. Then we came into this level, which we saw on the weekly chart as well. We came in this level and price turned around and started correcting. And now at the moment we are back at these levels where price came in and went for a sell-off, came in, another sell-off, and now came in and is here for another sell-off. Well, I'm going to zoom into the 4-hour chart, but you can also already see it on the daily chart. This was a move and a correction, then a second move and a correction, now a third move, which was kind of a little bit consolidating, and we had this is also a pin bar, of course, depending on the time frame you're watching, but this is price came in and sold off right away. So this is the this is what we are looking at the moment. So when we also use a trend line, we can see this setup. If this would have been a fake breakout, then we would have had a couple of touches on this one and this one. So I'm I'm a little bit into a fake out where price reacted strongly at the same level as it did before. So I'm confident to use the trend line like this. Well, on the 4-hour charts, let's make it a little bit. It's just a perfect touch, 1-2. And now here we are struggling with this level. Of course, you can see I'm not the only one who's looking at this trend line. People are into this trade. The bulls and the bears are at war at the moment. Are we going to break this level or are we going to move out? And just as today, right now, I am making this video, we can see the price came in one more time and it's starting to sell off for now. So I think this is kind of the range price is at the moment. So if we see an actual break, this has the potential to move further down, and we maybe come back for a retest and have another sell-off. So let's see what happens. This is all just an idea. It's not a price prediction. It's not set in stone that this is actually going to happen. But looking at this support level, it's pretty likely that if price starts to move in this area, that it gets retested and we see another move. It's pretty likely. It can also happen earlier or later on, or maybe price will consolidate first and come back for a pull that way. But this is an interesting setup, because to me it's interesting. So it's good to explain my thought process on this, so you guys know as well why that is. Let me switch to the daily chart. As you can see here, we had price trending to the upside, and now it looks like we are having within a level that actually matters. We are in this range at the moment in the bigger picture, and we just came in and we are starting to show some weakness again. So if this in fact is turning out as we are thinking it could be turning out, then we have an interesting move to the downside, which could give us an interesting risk reward. Well, there are different ways to enter this trade. Maybe this could be an entry, and just outside could be the stop loss. In that case, you have the potential for a 2.3. So that's quite a interesting risk reward ratio. You can potentially lose, for example, $10 or $100, and the potential of the trade is you can make $23 or $230 as well. So if you try to find trades like this overall, and let's say you have 10 trades, which 4 or 5 are not profitable, and 5 or 6 are profitable, with risk reward ratios like this, oh, at the end of the day or at the end of the month or whatever you're trading, you would be in profit. There is no percentage of being right or something. Being right or being wrong is something you have to leave at the door once you get into trading, because this is a potential setup. If price turns around and gets stopped out, that is what happens. We take a loss and we move on to find another one. If it does move and we continue to move in this range, then we have ourselves a profit. Losses are inevitable, so keep that in mind. So going back to the 4-hour chart, finally, this is the range price is in. On the daily, I put on the potential risk reward tool, which set the stop loss above here. Of course, we have this price action over here as well. So if we look at this, there is also reason to believe that if this the top of this channel stays intact, we could also be having a stop loss that actually makes sense. So with that in mind, another way to enter this trade could be enter on a break, maybe set your stop loss above here. Also, you can set your stop loss back in the channel, because if it's a fake breakout, you are you're out of the trade early. In that case, we still of course have the same potential in this trade, so that makes it a 4.4 risk reward ratio. So it's just, I don't know, certain rules you follow in your trading, but there are different ways to enter the market. In my book, I talk a lot about how to manage risk, because that's the most overlooked part of trading. Everybody can master technical analysis within a couple of weeks or months, but you know, if the risk management part is off, then there is nothing to be there's no making money in the long term. If you're interested in getting my book, let me show you just how. My book is free. It's called Trading: A Guide to Consistency. I wrote it after 8 years of trading, I think. It's about the first part is about trading in general. The second part is about all about technical analysis and trading strategies. And the third part is about all about risk management. So you can unlock your free copy by signing up through the link in the description. That is one of my preferred brokers. So if you trade with them, you don't pay anything for the book. You don't pay me anything. You just trade. And then I'm happy to help, of course. When you're set up and you verified your account, of course, made your first deposit and are ready to trade, send me a message if you're ready to go, and I'll be happy to send you the book right away. You can reach me at tradevision2020@gmail.com or my Instagram tradevision account. Send me a direct message, and I'll happy to answer your questions and send you the book. As a bonus, I want to also offer that I'm happy to review your trading plan or your trading strategy. Maybe with my experience, I can point out some flaws, and you know, by pointing out the flaws, it will help you not to lose money. Ask me anything you haven't found in the book. I'm happy to help. Also, questions about the book or things you've read. You know, let's keep an open line there, and let me help you in your trading career. And then last but not least, like I said a little bit, let's stay in contact also during your training journal, because if you have the best strategy, you will encounter some psychological things or motivational things, or just questions in general, like why isn't it working, or I had 3 losses in a row, is something off? Well, sometimes nothing is off, you just manage your risk properly and you're on the right track. And I think it's a good thing to be in contact about those things. So that's it for this video. I hope you find a great opportunity in this analysis, and manage your risk, and you know, it's education is what I stand for in my channel. So I hope it helps, and trade safe using your own rules and your own plan, of course, and see you in the next one.